Hello. So now we are going to discuss the latitude effect. So you saw the altitude effect, where you saw the variation of the cosmic ray intensity with respect to the height at a particular latitude. Now what we will be seeing, we shall be discussing the how the cosmic ray intensity varies with the latitude. So latitude effect is the variation of the cosmic ray intensity with latitude. So what they saw, that when the Goldilocks electroscope was placed at different latitudes of the earth, then how did the Goldilocks electroscope discharge? Was there any variation? Was there increase or decrease with respect to the different latitudes? So what happened, that the Clay, Millikan, Cameron, Compton, they had made certain sea voyages at different latitudes to observe the discharge of the gold leaf electroscope. So what did they conclude when they saw the observations of the gold leaf electroscope? So they saw that the cosmic ray intensity gradually increased by about 10% up to 50 degree north to 50 degree south. Supposing this is 0 degree equator, so when the voyages were made to move from the equator to the 50 degree north or from 50 degree south, so there was an increase in the intensity. So here you can see the intensity is increasing till 45 degree or 50 degree latitudes. So this is written here, that the cosmic ray intensity increased by about 10% about to 50 degree north, or you go towards the south direction, that is 50 degree south. So then when they reached at 50 degree north or 50 degree south, then if they made voyages beyond the 50 degree north or 50 degree south latitudes, there was no change in the intensity of the cosmic rays. So the cosmic ray intensity remains same thereafter. So the cosmic ray intensity saturated at 50 degree north or 50 degree south up to 90 degree north or 90 degree south. The latitude greater than 40 degree, the variation is very small. So when we see here that 40 degree, so from 40 degree to 50 degree, the variation is not much appreciable. So the variation is very, very small. And at 50 degree, the variation becomes saturated, and beyond 50 degree, there is no increase in the cosmic ray intensity. So there is a polar cap extending from poles to about 50 degree, where the intensity is same. So you can see from 50 degree north to 50 degree south, there is a change in the intensity, and this dip is called the polar cap. Is that clear? This dip is called the polar cap, and the point at which the cosmic ray intensity saturates, it stops increasing, that point is called as the knee point. So the latitude above which the variation with the latitude stops or becomes saturated, it becomes ceases, is called the knee of the curve. So these were the conclusions that were made by making the sea voyages at different latitudes. So next, what they saw when they compared the equator and the poles. So here we have the earth. So this is the north-south latitude, and this is the magnetic north-south line. This is the east-west direction. So what they saw, that when the particles were made to move towards the equator or it were made to move towards the poles, so these lines are showing the deflection that the particle suffered. And they saw that the particles were deflected most when they reached the equator, and they were deflected the minimum when they were at the pole points and at the poles. So when they reached at the poles, the particles were moving parallel to the poles. And they saw that the concentration is very much minimum at the equator. So at the equator, the Earth's magnetic field is perpendicular to the direction of motion of the charged cosmic ray particles. So you can see here, the magnetic field line is perpendicular to the direction of the motion of the charged cosmic ray particles. The particles suffer maximum force, as a result of which they suffer deflection. Hence, minimum number of particles are found at the equator than at the poles. So, very less number of particles are found at the equator than they are found at the poles. And at the poles, the particles approach parallel. Here you can see that this is the pole point. So, the particles are just moving parallel to the poles and they suffer minimum deflection. So, on entering the atmosphere, the charged particles are trapped by the magnetic field of the earth in two donut shaped belts called the Van Allen belts. So, here you can see this points. So, there are two zones where the concentration is quite high and the particles are getting trapped in these two donut shaped zones, and these two donut shaped zones are called as the Van Allen belts. So, the inner belt of the charged particles are found at a distance of 5000 kilometers, and these particles are caused by the high energy protons from the outer space. So, the particles that are trapped in the inner Van Allen belt is by the high energy protons which were formed by the outer space. And the outer belt, here you can see this outer belt. So, in this outer belt, which is at 16,000 kilometers, here low energy particle protons and electrons are found. So, high energy protons are found in the inner belt, whereas the low energy charged particle or electron protons are found in the outer Van Allen belt. So, and these belts surround the earth except at the poles. So, you can see here, this is the pole point. So, at this pole point, there is no Allen belt. The Allen belt particles are not having any particle at the pole point. They are just surrounding the earth except at the pole points. So, these were the conclusions, that with the change in the latitude, initially from equator till 50 degree north latitude or 50 degree south latitude, the cosmic ray intensity increased, beyond which there was no change in the cosmic ray intensity, and the particles had suffered a maximum force at the equator. Minimum number of particles were found at the equator than at the poles, and at the poles they suffered minimum deflection and the particles approached parallel to the earth's field. So, this is the latitude effect. So, next we will study the east-west direction effect, or the azimuth. So, now we are going to discuss the east-west direction effect, or the azimuth effect. So, what do you mean by the east-west direction effect? In the east-west direction effect, it is seen that the number of particles of the cosmic rays are not equal whether it is measured from the east direction or it is measured from the west direction. So, why is there a difference between the intensity of the cosmic ray if measured from the east direction and the west direction? So, this we shall discuss in this topic. So, Johnson and Street in 1933 saw that the intensity of the cosmic ray radiation from the eastward direction, if measured, and if measured from the westward direction at any place, at a particular place, is not same. So they had to think why this effect is there, why the intensity is not same if measured from east direction or it is measured from the west direction. So what was there, that it was very significant east-west direction effect, as this effect proposed the nature of the cosmic rays. It was helpful in determining whether the cosmic rays were of positively charged, it was negatively charged. So, what was the nature of the cosmic ray radiation? So, that nature was predicted by the east-west direction effect. So, if the cosmic ray particles had been uncharged, if the cosmic ray were uncharged particle, then the number of the particles at any place, whether it is measured from east direction or from the west direction, it would have been constant, it would have been same. But this case was not justified, it was coming out different. So, if the cosmic ray particles had been uncharged, the number of the cosmic ray particles would have been same that entered the Earth's atmosphere, and the inference, the conclusions that we made at a particular place would have been same. But the instrument measured different values. As we know that in the latitude effect, we had seen that the Earth has its own magnetic field with lines of force outside the Earth from south to north. It was rushing from south to north, and when the particles are approaching the Earth vertically, it is approaching the Earth vertically, the positively charged particle will be pushed towards east according to the Fleming's left hand rule. Everybody is familiar with the Fleming's left hand rule, that if it is coming with particular velocity and is applied at a particular magnetic field, then it would experience a force according to this left hand rule. If this is velocity, this is the magnetic field, then this is the force applied. So depending upon the velocity B and F, though, we can calculate the direction. So the particle, if it's approaching from the Earth and vertically, and if positively charged is pushed towards the east direction according to the Fleming's left hand rule, then they appear to come in a direction inclined to the west of the vertical. Similarly, if the positive are pushed towards east, the negatively charged particle will be pushed towards the west. So the concentration of particles will be different along the east and the west directions. So the negatively charged particles will come in large quantities from the east direction. Here the positively charged particles were coming from the west. Here it was seeming that the negatively charged particles are coming from the east direction. So the concentration of the charged particles is more in the east direction for the negatively charged, and the concentration of the positively charged particle is more in the west direction. So that is why there is a difference in the number of cosmic ray particles in the east and the west direction. And it is also seen that the east-west effect is more pronounced at the equator, and it is just absent at the poles. In the latitude effect also, we saw that the Van Allen belts were absent at the poles and it was more pronounced at the equator. So the effect is more pronounced at the equator and is absent at the poles. And most of the particles approach the Earth from west than east. So when the particles are approaching more from west, here we had seen that for the west direction, what were the particles? The particles were the positively charged particles. So the cosmic ray were composed of more positively charged particles as compared to the negatively charged particles. So the majority of the particles that approach the Earth from west than the east direction, and the majority of the particles are charged. But the charged particles are also the positively charged particles, not the negative. The majority is of the positively charged particles. And this whole effect is called the east-west direction, which led to propose that the intensity of the cosmic ray radiation from the eastward direction and the westward direction is not same at any particular place if it is measured. So this was the east-west direction. Also, there was sometimes it was thought that the sun was the major source of the emission of the cosmic rays. So if it was the sun, then the intensity of the cosmic ray must have been more during the day and it would be less during the night, because if sun is the source, so sun is not at the night. So but later on by experiments, it was found that the intensity does not matter upon the day or night. It is same if it is calculated at the daytime, and it is same if it is calculated at the night time. So the assumption that the sun is the source of the cosmic ray was overruled. So now we come to the components of the cosmic ray, which are classified as soft component or the hard component. So, the basis on which the soft and hard components are classified as, the Millikan and Cameron measured the absorption of cosmic rays in water near the Earth's surface. That whether there is cosmic rays present inside the water also. So, they found that the cosmic rays are not homogeneous. The value is not same at all the place regarding the penetration power. If the penetration power is calculated or we calculate the energy, so we can calculate the cosmic ray intensity. So it was found that the cosmic ray intensity is not homogeneous regarding the penetration power. Means for a particular depth, there must be some value, and for a particular depth, there is some other value. So the homogeneity, the constancy of the values is not same. It is different in different directions like that. So high energy particles have also been detected of the cosmic rays at a depth of 1400 meter inside the seawater. So these cosmic rays have a high penetration power which can penetrate deep inside the seawater too. So the components are divided into two categories, that is the soft and the hard components. So let us look at what are the various properties on the basis of which the components of cosmic rays are divided. So first is the property that how much of the total percentage of the cosmic rays are soft components and how much of the total cosmic rays constitute the hard component. So it has been found that the 20% of the total cosmic rays is the soft component, and sometimes 20% is also regarded as 30%. So the variation of the soft component is lying between 20 to 30%, whereas the hard component constitutes the 70% of the total cosmic rays. So major component is the hard, whereas the lesser component is of the soft component. So it has been observed that the soft components get absorbed up to 0.6 per meter of water. So it is being absorbed to 0.6 per meter of the water, and the penetration power of the soft component is not more than 10 centimeter of lead. Means it could only penetrate the few millimeters of the lead, whereas the hard component has higher penetration power and it can penetrate to 1 meter of the lead. More than 1 meter of the lead it can penetrate. So penetration power of the hard component is more as compared to the soft component. So because the penetration powers are different, so that is why the homogeneity is not equal. So that is why it is said here in this point that cosmic rays are not homogeneous regarding the penetration power. If there is a percentage of more soft component, then it would penetrate only 10 centimeter, whereas the hard component would penetrate up to 1 meter of the particular substance. So the homogeneity is not feasible. So we had found that the proportion of the soft component, this soft component proportion increases with the increase in altitude to about 15 kilometer, and afterwards 15 kilometers there is a decrease in the intensity of the soft component. So this is the same curve that we had expected in the case of the altitude effect, where the cosmic ray intensity had been increased to a height of 20 to 25 kilometers, and then thereafter it had decreased. So the same pattern is observed by the soft component, where the proportion is increasing with altitude to 15 kilometer, and thereafter the components is decreasing. It is showing a decrease in its behavior. So I hope that you have understood the altitude effect, latitude effect, east-west direction effect, and the basis on which the cosmic rays are divided as soft component or the hard component. So meet you again. Thank you.